Welcome back to Ask an Expert. I'm Stan Voynick, Chief Technology Officer here at Sierra-Olympia Technologies. Today, I'll be answering some of our most frequently asked questions about how our OGI technology works and what kind of gases it can detect. First, let's step outside for a demo, though. Behind me, we have set up some gas containers. These are different containers, combinations in some cases of straight methane gas, and in other cases, a 50-50 mixture of methane and propane. You can see that the wind is blowing today. This is going to make it a bit of a challenging day because the wind is sweeping through here and blowing away the very gases that we're trying to detect, but we'll see if we can see them with our OGI camera. When we apply our optical gas imaging camera, OGI, to the scene, we get a whole different view. This camera has a very narrow band IR filter in it, which is tuned specifically to the absorption band of a number of short chain hydrocarbons. We'll talk about what those are in just a moment. But when we use the OGI camera to view that image, what we see is something different than what you get in the visible. We can actually see the infrared energy from behind the gases being absorbed by the gases as it comes through, and therefore the plumes of gas show up either dark or light, depending on what the thermal situation is. Even with this wind, you can see blowing these plumes immediately to the side, and these are very small plumes. These are tiny bottles here. If we were in an industrial setting, we might have canisters much larger than this, 10, 100 times larger. Or if we're in a refinery type setting, we might have tanks thousands of times larger than this, generating hydrocarbons internally. And what we want to see in that case is this gas leaking out? Let's come back inside where it's not as loud or windy as it is out there. So we saw how we can detect the gas outside in the challenging condition. The question we get quite often is, what gases can we detect? Our OGI camera works by having a very narrow band optical filter in front of the detector. That filter is tuned to the range where the common short chain hydrocarbons have a strong absorption band. Now, when I say the common short chain hydrocarbons, these are all of the most familiar gases that we're familiar with, especially in the oil and gas industry. Starting from the low end, although I might not get these in order, are things like methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane has 5 carbons in it, hexane has 6 carbons in it, heptane, and so on all the way up the chain. And also variations of these with that aren't just the simple hydrocarbons, but that have different other groups coming off of them. Now the short chain hydrocarbons are the ones that our OGI camera is specifically tuned to. It can't see every gas. For example, ammonia, that's got a nitrogen at the center instead of a hydrogen, and the bonds in that molecule don't vibrate the same way as the hydrocarbons do, so ammonia is a gas that we don't detect. Another gas that's often of interest is carbon dioxide, and that's another gas that this particular OGI camera does not detect because it has an IR absorption band that's away in a different spot from the place that we have ours tuned to detect the hydrocarbons. These gas canisters and the barbecue propane tanks that we've been looking at today are just a small example of the kinds of things that are used out in industry. Like I say, you might have canisters and containers that are hundreds or thousands or more of times larger than what we're working with here today. We experiment with these small ones so that we can tune up the performance of our camera and demonstrate how great a job it does at detecting small amounts of leakage. What we're really trying to do in the long run is be able to go out in the field and see pipelines, refineries, and other industrial processes where it's important to detect the leakage of hydrocarbons to protect our environment, to protect our lives, safety, and so on. I hope this has answered your questions about how the OGI camera works and what are the gases that it can detect. To find out more information, visit our sierraolympia.com website. I'm Stan Voynick. This has been Ask an Expert. Thanks for joining me.